Hey guys, how you going? This is Eddie the Magic Monk. Welcome to the first video in our Learn How to Program Games in Visual Basic series of videos. And to start on this series, you probably need to have done the Visual Basic programming videos before. So that you can understand everything that we're doing in the games programming series. And if you're confused about what I'm talking about, it probably means that you haven't seen the basic programming videos before this. So I suggest you watch that before trying out this series of videos. So in lesson one, all we want to achieve is have a character in your game where you can use your arrow keys to move the player around on the screen. So right now I'm pressing up, down, left, right to move the player. And so when I hold down the key, the player keeps moving in that direction until I let go of the key. Alright, by the way, this character sprite, the image, was downloaded from www.lostgarden.com if you want to download this picture and use it in your program. So yeah, try to do this first before looking at the answers that I'm about to give you. So if you can already do that, then you can skip the rest of this video. Otherwise, keep watching. Okay, so here's the coding that allows this to happen. Firstly, you need a form, and you need the character object, a picture box object. And so that's just the picture box. And you also need the timer one object. So drag these two objects onto the screen. The timer one object, timer object is here, and the picture box object is here. Drag them onto the screen. Added a new timer. The picture box object load up the picture into the image property here. So click on that and import the picture so that you can put it in your picture box. So this picture I just downloaded from lostgarden.com. And then let's have a look at the coding behind in the background. So we have four variables that you need to declare in the beginning. You have a move right variable, move up, move left, move down. All of these are boolean variables, which means they can only be true or false. And the first event you're gonna program in is the keydown event. And that means that when someone presses the key, this is what happens. If they press the right key, then I'm gonna change the variable move right to true. If they press the up key, then move up's gonna be true. If they press the move left key, if they press the left key, the move left will be true, and so on. And then I also need the key up event. What is the key up event? It is when you release the key. So the key down event is what you want the program to do to execute when you press down the key, when you hold the key down. Sorry, not hold the key down. When you press the key, this is going to happen. And then this is what the program will execute as soon as you release the key. So this is what happens as soon as you press the key, and this is what happens as soon as you release the key. So when I release the right arrow key, the move right variable becomes false. And that's why the character stops moving right as soon as I let go of the key. And then move up, same thing. The variable will be false for move up. Left arrow key, down arrow key. So far from the key down event to the key up event, all we have done is changing the variables true and false, and it's not actually going to move the picture. So what we want to do next is we want to program the timer. Now let's have a look at the timer object. The timer is an object that ticks every 10 milliseconds. Every 10 milliseconds, we're going to execute these instructions. So what are the instructions? Well, if the move right variable is true, then it's going to execute this statement here to move the picture box to the right. By changing the left property, by adding 5 to the left property, which is the left coordinate, the x coordinate of our picture box. If move left is true, we're going to also change the same property, except we're going to minus 5 instead of plus 5. Moving up and down, the property you have to change is the top property. If you do minus 5, it moves it upwards, and if you do plus 5, it moves it downwards. So there's the instructions you have to put in for the timer. And lastly, you want to start the timer as soon as the form loads. So as soon as the form loads, you're going to start the timer, and then everything should work when you execute this program. Now, this is the most basic thing you can do in terms of games programming. So if you can't do this, it's unlikely that you'll be able to do anything else in programming games. So I suggest that you guys master this part of the program before you continue to the next section. Okay, see you next time.